Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 23, where we are going to look at the anterior compartment of the leg. And we're really only going to have you identify one of the muscles. There's four, if you recall from the learning objective or lecture videos. But we're only going to identify one, the one that I think is the easiest to identify, in the primary dorsiflexor, which is the tibialis anterior. And this is going to be the most medial and as well as the most superficial muscle in the anterior compartment. You can see that it is lying against the surface of the tibia. This is the tibia. You can actually see the bone right here. So it is lying right on that lateral surface of the tibia. And this long tendon begins about halfway down the leg, and you can see it extending all the way to the medial side. I'll kind of draw a line there, the medial side of the foot region. Now, one thing you can also see in this image is this white portion right here, which is remnants of the deep fascia. Recall, the deep fascia in the anterior compartment is quite thick. It is going to cover the anterior compartment very tightly. And so if there were any type of injury that would allow blood to kind of enter into this compartment, that deep fascia doesn't allow for much expansion in this region. So that could lead to compression syndrome. So you do see a bit of that right there, which is more robust than you'll see in some of the other areas. In fact, in a very careful dissection, like this one was, we still weren't able to remove some of that deep fascia in order to see the muscle belly because it is so, so closely adhered. Okay, so that is what we are locating in this anterior compartment. Again, that tibialis anterior is going to be the most superficial muscle of the anterior compartment, and therefore it is the one that we are going to identify in a practical setting. All right, thank you for your time here, and I will see you at the next station.